I'm Simon Ditchburn. I'm the managing director of the Tudor Group of Companies, and today we've come to Bangkok in the glorious Thai sunshine to make a concrete sandwich. In our last video, we took you to the insulation company that was Easy Panel in Pattaya, and we took you through the process of exactly how the insulation works and how that's going to become the filling of a real concrete sandwich. Well, all of those panels have been delivered now to K Group, which is in Bang Nar, just outside of Bangkok. And K Group is the precast concrete company that physically is going to sandwich everything together. The first part of the process to actually make these walls is to physically make a frame that represents a complete wall. Now, this is laid out in the full width, height and thickness of the wall that we need, depending on the different types. Now, the insulation panel is first laid into the frame just as a dry fitting, because at this stage we've got to check that the electrics are in the correct position, the water is in the correct position. This gives you your last check before the concrete is actually poured. In a minute, when the concrete arrives, we'll actually be removing these panels, pouring the first layer of concrete, resetting the panel back into the wet concrete so the concrete gets chance to bind itself around all of the caging, and then the top layer of concrete will be poured on top. So the whole thing, the entire wall, can be made in one pouring of concrete. You can see now that we actually have a complete row of a production line here. So we're not making one wall at a time, we're actually making about 20 walls at a time. And now that the insulation has been removed, you can see it's not just a frame, this is actually a mold. And the bottom of the mold, we have a sheet of steel, which makes that beautiful smooth finish on the backside of the concrete. Now, I'm standing within what will be a door frame. So this is an opening later that doesn't have any concrete go inside it, and on the back side where we have an electric socket, we have little small plates of steel which will be positioned exactly where the electric switch or socket comes, so once again that doesn't get concrete poured inside it. Here's the first part of the process. You can see behind me, they pour the concrete directly into the bottom of the mould to a thickness of about 1.5 inches. Now that represents one side of the wall. Now while that concrete is still wet, we'll be lifting the insulation panel into the bottom of the mould, still being wet, so the concrete can actually mould itself around the steel reinforcing. So things are getting a little bit close to me now, so I'm going to step out the way and let you actually watch the process as it happens. Now with the concrete still wet, they're going to lift the insulation panel into that bottom surface of concrete. Here you can see the second side of the wall being poured, and the concrete just quite simply goes straight on top of the insulation. That will be then leveled off, vibrated to make sure that everything goes in between the reinforcing steel, and we've pretty much got a finished wall. A big thank you there today to K Group. They let us come in with the camera and actually film the process, and you can see the finished result behind us. There they all are, all lined up ready for the delivery down to the condominium. So that's where we've got to go next and show you the installation process.